can't believe Horace is dead.
I can't believe we left Brian in the car with the windows up.
I'm gonna pee!
Listen, I just feel awful about this. Horace was a good bartender and a good guy. I wish there was something I could do.
Oh, we know you didn't mean it, Jerome. It's just a terrible situation. Like when you're the only one at the table where the waiter doesn't say good order.
I'll have the halibut.
Ah, great choice. One of the chef's specialties. You'll love it. It was caught fresh less than 10 miles from here.
I'll have the New York strip steak.
Mmm, my absolute favorite dish here. It is a spectacular cut, superbly seasoned, and the marbling is some of the best I've ever seen.
And I'll have the chicken.
Mm-hmm.
Good afternoon. I'd just like to say that before today, I didn't know the Munsters were driving around in a funeral car.
I'm beginning to think everything on that show was a big joke.
I just like... When you lose... There's so much...
Thank you, Quagmire. Perhaps there are some men who would like to say a few words.
Horace owned the clam for over 30 years. During that time, he touched all of our lives. He was a great bartender and a great friend. And so let us take a look back on his life through this video, commemorating all the DUIs that he was responsible for.
I will remember you. Will you remember me? Don't let your life pass you by.
Ouch. You think it's cool to go drinking right after Horace's funeral?
Of course, it's what he would have wanted. Listen, we all gotta move on, like the Secret Service did on November 23rd, 1963.
All right, guys, I know that yesterday was a rough one for us, but it's with great pride that I'm gonna turn this zero into a one.
All right!
Nichols, you should go home and change.
What the hell? Hey, pal, what are you doing? This is our bar.
Not anymore. Horace owed more than this place is worth, so it's the bank's now. I'm sorry, but the Drunken Clam is permanently closed.
Closed?
That was the start of the dark times. The banks took our bars, our businesses, and then our homes. A change had to be made. A change only one man could make. I am the Windmaker. And I shoot monkeys now.
We now return to Joni Loves Chris Brown.
Joni! Chris! Welcome to the party! Can I offer you some punch?
No, thanks. I had some in the car.
Joni Loves Chris Brown was taped in front of a very uncomfortable studio audience.
Man, it really sucks they closed down the clam.
Yeah, but I mean, this is good, right? I mean, as long as we got a place to drink and a restroom for businessmen to have homosexual encounters.
Hey, thanks for the sex.
Thank you for notarizing those documents.
Peter, what's going on down here? Why are there beer bottles all over the floor?
Oh, we needed a new spot to drink, Lois.
Forget it, Peter. You're not turning our living room into a bar.
Oh, come on, Lois. We gotta have a place to drink. Drinking is the only thing holding this friendship together. Everything we try to do sober just ends badly.
I just don't think a good way to start a screenplay is 400 years ago in Bethesda, Maryland.
Yeah, and don't you think it's confusing that every character in the movie is named Movie Guy?
Come on, you guys. The Oscars are next week, so let's get this done.